Welcome to episode 19 of the Encouragement Series. I bring you greetings of joy in the name of our ever-reliable Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And on behalf of the family of Church of the Resurrection, 1004 Estate, Victoria Island, in the Anglican Diocese of Lagos, I say you will fulfill your life. It is true that a thick cloud of uncertainty that covered the sky of our nations have not cleared off. But I want you to remember that the one who brings hope to the hopeless and caused light to reign over darkness is on the throne far above the cloud. In the midst of all that is going on in the world today, I want you to know that your life is not a game of chance. Your life is not an accident because God does not play dice. Your life is a divine package and it will find fulfillment in the hands of Him who packaged it. In Psalm 138 verse 16, the psalmist says, "You saw me before I was born and scheduled each day of my life before I began to breathe. Every day was recorded in the book." In Exodus chapter 2, we read about the birth of Moses. Though the time of his birth was not the best of time, but the one who packaged his destiny was on top of the situation. And the death that killed others did not kill him. God did not only make a way for his survivor, God made him a vessel of honor. Moses was not counted among the dead. He was counted among the living. At the end of this pandemic, you will be counted among the living. I pray for you also that the grace of God that preserves his elect in the days of calamity will be upon your life and your family in the name of Jesus. In Joshua chapter 6, from verse 22 to 23, the word of God says, "Then they utterly destroyed with the edge of the sword all that was in the city, both men and women, young and old, and horse and sheep and donkey. But Joshua had said to the two men who had spied out the country, 'Go into the harlot's house and bring her here and all that she has, as you sworn to her.' The young men went in and brought out Rahab and every member of her family. When Jericho was destroyed, noble men and women died. The king died. Prince and princesses, they died. But the grace of God located Rahab." Hallelujah. Rahab was saved where others died. Because in Joshua chapter 2, she had by faith taken refuge in the God who is able to deliver in the days of trouble. I say again that your life is not an accident because it has divine purpose, and the purpose of your life will be fulfilled. No matter what the tempest and storm of life throws at you, if you will by choice come to the place of covenant, the place of agreement with your God and Maker, He will deliver you. Don't leave your life to chance. Rahab decided to identify with the only true God, and her decision brought her salvation. The truth is that the Father you do not serve, you do not deserve. If you will come to the path of life and assurance today, your life now and eternity will be secured. In 1 Kings chapter 1, we read about how Solomon came to the throne of his father David. As Absalom wanted that throne by all means, he fought for the throne. He didn't get it. Adonijah gathered some men around himself to proclaim him as king, yet he did not sit on the throne. Solomon may be considered by many men of his generation to be unqualified for the throne, considering how the mother Bathsheba came to be one of the wives of David. But when God qualifies you, no one can disqualify you. I pray for you. Whatever throne or height the Lord has set for you, you will surely get there, no matter the dark cloud of uncertainty. God raised men that spoke on behalf of Solomon. And King David said to Bathsheba, "As the Lord lives, who hath redeemed my soul out of all distress, assuredly Solomon your son will reign after me, and he will sit on my throne in my place." I pray for you again that God will raise men that will speak for your favor in the place where it matters, in the name of Jesus Christ. The angels of God will plead the case of your children in the name of Jesus Christ. The desire of Bathsheba over her son Solomon was granted. God will fulfill your desire for your children in the name of Jesus Christ. David said, "As the Lord lives, who redeemed my soul out of all distress, the Lord, your God, will redeem you and your household from all distress in your life, including that of coronavirus, in the name of Jesus Christ." What was needed for Solomon to reign was for David to just give the order. David did, and Solomon became the king of Israel. In the name of Jesus Christ, God will give an order concerning your healing and your divine restoration in the name of Jesus Christ. God will give an order concerning your home and the lives of your children. Our ever-living God will give an order concerning your business, your finance, your marriage, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray again that God will give an order that will take away your fear and your worries in the name of Jesus Christ. And you will dwell in absolute peace. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. Amen.